receives a letter from a distant relative, the wealthy landowner Nicholas Van Rijn. He invites one of their daughters for an extended visit to his Hudson Valley estate, Drakenwijk. 18-year-old Miranda, bored with the local suitors and her commonplace life on the farm, leaps at the chance for escape. She immediately falls under the spell of Nicholas and his mansion, mesmerized by its Gothic towers, flowering gardens, and say something controversial, which is that I did not enjoy it. I didn't even finish it. I got about halfway through and DNF'd it, which is did not finish in Bookstagram speak. It just wasn't for me. Yeah. set by season, which is why it's called a country year. It is nonfiction. Look at that. Very intricate. Isn't that beautiful? See, that says summer. Obviously is very, very different than a ghost story. his friend George Tallboys, who has recently returned from making his fortune in Australia. When George suddenly vanishes from the house under mysterious circumstances, Robert begins to delve into his friend's past and becomes convinced that Lady Audley may not be as ignorant of events or as innocent as she seems. As compelling as the sensation novels by Wilkie Collins, Lady Audley's secret is a disturbing exploration of the dark side of respectable Victorian society, featuring one of the great villainesses of the 19th century literature. So, as it mentions, Lady Audley has a secret, and it is very good. It is these were called like sensation novels back in the day, and I can see why. It's, you know, it's not just like the most sensational thing I've ever read nowadays, but for the time, I can see how it probably was very sensational. And it's really good. Mary Elizabeth Braddon is a very good writer.
Leave her.